A chart is a tool you can use in Excel to communicate your data graphically. Not only are charts easy to create, they are often very easy for your audience to understand. Charts allow users to more easily see the meaning behind the numbers in the spreadsheet and make showing comparisons and trends a lot easier. For example, if I asked you to review this spreadsheet and tell me if sales are increasing or decreasing in 2008, could you do so quickly? What about if you looked at this chart? As you can see, sometimes a chart really is an effective tool for communicating information. Every chart starts with data, so let's take a look at a spreadsheet for a small business called Coastal Candle Company. We can see from the spreadsheet that we have salespeople and some assorted data. To show you how to create a chart, let's use the information on the summary sheet. So we'll just click it to select it. Now, you can see that this view gives us a summary of the salespeople and the dollar amount in sales for each month. Let's create a chart that compares the sales of all our salespeople month by month. To do this, select the information that you want to chart, including the column titles and the row labels. Then click the Insert tab. In the Charts group, you can see several different types of charts. Let's take a look at some of the most popular ones. Columns are often used to compare items. We'll probably want to use the Columns command to compare our salespeople. Line charts are great to display trends over time. So let's say you want to see how a particular product sold over the course of a year. A line graph would be a great chart to use because you could use one line to represent that product and additional lines to represent other products. Pie charts can be used to represent items or pieces that combined together form a total amount. For example, if I asked a class of 30 students the question, "Where do you use the internet?" I could display the results in a pie chart. If you have multiple items to compare, a bar chart might meet your needs. And you have area, scatter, and other charts as well. Don't worry, if you're not sure how you can use these, just hover over the commands and a box will appear with some information about how each chart is best used. Now, let's get to the fun stuff. To insert a chart, click the command of your choice from the Charts group. I think a column chart will work well for this, so we'll just click that. Now, we see a number of chart types to choose from. You have so many options. For this example, let's just choose a basic 2D clustered column. I know the name of this chart because it displays when I hover my pointer over it. Now, just left-click it to select it, and there you go, your chart appears. We can see how much each salesperson sold each month and how their sales vary from month to month. Our salespeople, which are the row titles in the sales, now appear on the bottom of the chart. The column titles from the worksheet, January, February, and March, are now represented in the charts graphically and labeled to the right in the legend. The legend tells you which color represents what data in the spreadsheet. We can see that the blue bar represents January sales. On the left side of the chart, Excel has created a scale of numbers to help you understand what the column heights of each month means. The height of each column is in proportion to the data in the cells. Now that you know how to insert a chart, let's take a look at some of the chart tools. Once you insert a chart, a new set of chart tools that are arranged into three tabs will appear above the ribbon. These are only visible when the chart is selected. Let's take a look at the Design tab first. If you want to change the chart type after you create your chart, you can do so from this tab. Just click Change Chart Type, and from the menu that appears, select another chart type. You can stay with the column charts, or even choose something completely different. I like the column charts, but I think I want this 3D version of the clustered column, so I'll just click it. and then click OK. Your chart type will change. Right now, the chart shows in 3D how each salesperson did month by month, in essence, comparing their January sales to their February sales to their own March sales. But you can change what is being compared by simply clicking the Switch Row Column Data command. Clicking this command will switch the info that appears vertically and horizontally on the X and Y axis. Now, the chart compares salespeople to each other in each month. You can see that a simple click of a button can change the chart significantly. You can switch the charts back to the original view by clicking Switch Row Column again. You can modify your charts in a lot of other ways too. Okay, stay with me here. This may remind you a little of high school math. This chart has two axes. On the left is the vertical axis, also known as the y-axis. Right now, the vertical axis displays a scale of numbers which we can use along with the columns to determine how much each salesperson sold each month. Here at the bottom is a horizontal axis, also called the x-axis, which displays a salesperson's name. Excel gives us the ability to change the chart layout and add chart titles and text that describe our axes. On the Design tab, find the Chart Layouts group. You can click the More arrow to view all your options and just left-click an option to select it. This one looks good. It lets me add a chart title, but if it's not what you want, just choose another one. This one just jumbles the text and doesn't work for this chart. But this one is what I want. It allows me to label both axes and give my chart a title. Now you can type the titles directly in the chart. I'll call my chart First Quarter 2008 Sales. And then on the y-axis, type sales amount, and on the x-axis, type sales people. You can do a few other things from the Design tab. For instance, you can apply a chart style by selecting an option from the Chart Styles group. This can dramatically change the look of your chart. Another great command is the Move Charts command. This command does exactly what it states. It moves the chart. Let's see how this works. Just click the command and a dialog box appears. Right now, the objects in the radio button is selected, and summary appears in the drop-down list. This is reminding us that the chart currently appears on the summary sheet. You can change this so the chart appears on another existing worksheet, or select New Sheet, name the sheet, and click OK. Now the chart appears in its own sheet. There are way too many chart options for us to go into all in this one video. The Layout tab really gives you some serious control over how things are displayed in your chart, specifically the labels, axes, and background groups. I encourage you to explore this tab and those three groups in the commands. Also, take a look at the Format tab. From here, you can really change the visual appearance of your chart so that it works with the rest of your spreadsheet. As you saw, adding a chart takes somewhere around 10 seconds, but with all the Excel tools all at your disposal, you can spend as much time as you want really formatting your chart to meet your needs.